The Ecological Sequestration Trust, planning for the transition to a sustainable world. As decision makers, as leaders, as people, what can we do to ensure our plans and actions are fit for the future, are sustainable? Climate change, resource scarcity and poverty are increasingly costly. Business as usual is not an option. How can nations, regions, cities, businesses and communities face these challenges and find the opportunities? By considering the interconnected and complex nature of the decisions we make, we can be smarter about planning for our future. We won't meet today's challenges with yesterday's thinking. How can we make better decisions in planning, development, and financing? What part can each of us play in shaping the future we need? How can we ensure that investment decisions lead to a better future, the resilient future we want? The Ecological Sequestration Trust and our partners are creating the world's first platform to help do this. It's called resilience.io, and we are demonstrating its capabilities working with an expert team in Ghana. Resilience.io is a tool that brings global expertise to facilitate local decision making. It is created and maintained by leading modelers and scientists with multi-sector expertise and is designed to support decision making for greater global resilience. So how does it work? Install the app to build a digital representation of everything that makes your region function by adding your data and the relevant activities from the Open Access Library. Add details of projects to compare their performance over time and share the evidence to build consensus and secure investments. How can we develop resilience.io for your city region? The first resilience.io prototype has been developed to tackle the water and sanitation issues faced in and around the capital of Ghana. A local team of technical experts and policymakers involved in water and sanitation was formed and meets regularly to identify data sources, discuss assumptions, and agree on priority topics. They are now using resilience.io to inform policy decisions and secure new investments to achieve a more resilient Ghana. This work is funded by the UK Government Department for International Development and is a part of the Cities Alliance Future Cities Africa feasibility project. The urgency to act now is global. How can every urban area benefit from resilience.io? Is there a roadmap? Yes. The Roadmap 2030 report was co-created to provide a practical action plan for implementing the global goals and sustainable development objectives nationally and in cities. With the roadmap, governments, businesses, and communities partner in smarter ways to build the enabling environment. We are working with Gaiasoft to codify the roadmap into a simple self-assessment tool so that cities and regions can get started now to build the enabling environment. New tools for collaborative, human, ecological, economic resource systems, or CHEAR management, are urgently needed, and resilience.io in Ghana is the first example of this new integrated approach in use. Resilience.io will cover transport, water, food, energy, human health, agriculture, ecological systems, income, jobs and innovation, economy, climate change, natural hazard risks. In fact, all the significant systems that interact and together describe the functioning of a region. This creates the evidence for teams to work collaboratively and develop pipelines of bankable projects that attract new investment through dedicated funds. As well as in Ghana, we'll be working with other demonstrator regions in Africa, Asia, and Europe. Resilience.io is being created as a fully accessible open source tool that can be downloaded for any city region in the world. We imagine the tool being used in 10,000 locations by 2030, all working to implement the global goals and the new urban agenda. Ghana has shown it has the ambition to be a world leader in integrated planning with resilience.io. Visit the resilience.io website to learn with our global community and contribute to a transformational change.